Sometimes we get the question, why doesn't the Utah SDR cover the CW portion of a band? Or why isn't all of a certain band being covered by the SDR? When this question first came up, we were confused. Other than 6 meters, all of the amateur bands 2 meters and below are covered in their entirety on the Utah SDR. So what did they mean? It quickly occurred to us that they were referring to not being able to see an entire amateur band when they brought up the WebSDR server. Perhaps this is because they were not yet accustomed to the way things worked. We'll be the first to admit that the user interface of the WebSDR screen can seem to be intimidating, much like that of a brand new radio. But there are a few fundamental features that new, and possibly seasoned, users might have overlooked, and this may include the way the waterfall zoom works. In November of 2021, many of the receivers of the Northern Utah WebSDR were upgraded. Before this, we had to cover many of the HF bands with several receivers. 80 meters required 3 receivers, and 20 and 40 each required 2. And with these relatively narrow slices of spectrum, it was still pretty easy to visualize even narrow signals. After this upgrade, we could cover these bands with a single wider receiver. Even with the new wider bandwidth receivers, there are some bands, namely 10 and 2 meters, that still require more than one receiver to cover the entire band. Back to the lower HF bands, these new receivers can cover up to 768 kHz of bandwidth, larger than any of the HF bands below 10 meters. One problem is that with a waterfall display that wide, it can be difficult to tune signals visible on the waterfall, especially narrow ones. So code was added to automatically zoom the waterfall in on frequencies where the WebSWR was tuned by default. While this provides a better view to the most used portions of the bands, this may have the effect of causing new users to presume that only the portion that is actually visible on the screen was that actually covered. But this is not the case. If you go to any band and you don't see the full coverage, the first thing you should do is click on the Max Out button. Doing this will expand the waterfall to the full extent of the receiver's coverage, allowing you to see all frequencies covered by that band's receiver. Once you've decided on a frequency, or even a general frequency within the band, click on the part of the waterfall with the displayed frequency numbers, or simply enter the frequency into the box. At that point, you can either stay fully zoomed out, but you'll probably want to zoom in even closer. To do this, you can use the Zoom In button. Clicking it several times will provide a closer view of the spectrum around the frequency to which you are tuned. Conversely, you can use the Max In button to fully zoom in with just one step, or adjust it however you like using the Zoom Out and Zoom In buttons. Yet another way that you can zoom on the waterfall is to hover the mouse over the portion of the waterfall with the signals, and then roll the wheel on your mouse. You must be over the part with the signals, and not the part with the numbers and labels for this to work. Finally, if when you are hovering over the part of the waterfall with the signals, you can press and hold the left mouse button and drag the waterfall back and forth to see another portion of the band. Again, if it's the waterfall you want to move, you must be over the part with the signals when you do the press and hold of the mouse button. If you do this in the portion with the frequency numbers, you'll retune the receiver, but that's a topic of another video. Thanks for watching.